ったですね。先ほど言ってですが、ちょっと。I'm Hiranishi Kawa from National Institute for Materials Science, Japan. Today I'd like to be talking about the effect of mean stress on small particular growth rate on broken steel with several simulated hard heat treatment. This is the contents of this presentation. I'd like to introduce several small particular growth data for under mean stress conditions. After that, I will discuss about closure effect and microstructure effect before the summary of this presentation. First, I'd like to show the fatigue issue for weld joint. As you know, fatigue data for weld joint is very scattered, as shown here. This is because weld joint has a lot of complex effective factors such as variable microstructure, heat affected zone, residual stress, stress concentration, and so on. But if we can consider these factors correctly, such scattered data should be divided reasonably like this. And this is very useful in engineering aspect. So this is to develop the evaluation method for this complex factors. This study is focusing on microstructure and residual stress as a first step. And by the way, this is an example for fatigue initiation and propagation process. And it is well known that small crack growth is sensitive to microstructure compared to long crack. So to clarify the microstructure effect and to discuss the microstructure effect, in this study, also focusing on the small fatigue crack growth property of the material. And so the objective of this study is to evaluate the effect of microstructure and mean stress on small fatigue crack growth rate. For this purpose, first we prepare the simulated hard specimens by heat treatment like this. After that, we conduct a small fatigue crack growth test. And finally, I will discuss about the applicable parameter to evaluate the small fatigue crack growth rate, such as delta K, epsilon to NA, and so on. And I will also discuss about the crack closure effect. In this part, I will show the DIC, digital image correlation technique, to detect the crack opening point for micro crack. The material used in this study is low carbon steel, as shown here. The microstructures are controlled by heat treatment with controlled heat peak temperature and cooling rate. The microstructures are perlite and granularity ferrite for material A, and upper bainite for material B, and martensite for material C. Tensile strengths are also described here. Small fatigue crack growth behavior is successfully observed by microscope. Fatigue test conditions are shown here. And then I'd like to start talking about the result and discussion of this presentation. First, I'd like to show the mean stress effect on S-N curve. And this is the S-N curve for material A, B, and C. Solid mark is obtained under zero mean stress condition, and open mark is obtained under tensile mean stress condition. Fatigue life is degraded by tensile mean stress, but this tensile mean stress effect is able to be fixed by Smith-Watson top-by equation, as shown here. This equation is known as the conventional equation to fix the mean stress effect. This is expressed as strain amplitude, materials constant, maximum stress, and Young's modulus. Fatigue life is mainly occupied by small fatigue crack growth life. So such parameter should be related to small fatigue crack growth also. So one of the points of this presentation is discuss about the relationship between such parameter and small fatigue crack growth rate. And then I'd like to show the small fatigue crack growth data. These are the data for material A and material B. These small particular growth data is evaluated with using fracture mechanics parameter delta k. Open mark obtained by zero mean stress condition and solid mark as a tensor mean stress condition. It is well known that fracture mechanics parameter is difficult to use for evaluating the small fatigue crack growth rate. This result also more difficult evaluated by delta k. So we consider the another parameter, H2NA type parameter. This parameter is known as a simple parameter for evaluating small fatigue crack growth rate. This is expressed as strain amplitude and material constant crack length. This slide shows the evaluated result using H2NA parameter. As you can see here, all fatigue data under zero mean stress conditions are uniformly evaluated by this parameter. But however, fatigue data under tensor mean stress cannot evaluated by this parameter. To fix the tensor mean stress effect, we propose the epsilon equivalent to a parameter. This is a combination of epsilon to NA parameter and Smith-Watson topi SWT parameter as shown before. As mentioned before, this parameter may be related to small fatigue growth rate also. This shows a relative result by using epsilon equivalent to NA parameter. As you can see here, all fatigue data are uniformly evaluated by this type of parameter. It is clarified that this parameter is available to evaluate the small fatigue crack growth rate as a simple parameter. But we have to know the background of this parameter. To know the background, we cannot ignore the crack closure effect. So in this study, typical digital image correlation technique is used to directly measure the crack closure effect, crack opening and closing point. This image shows an example of the DSC analyzed result during the loading and unloading condition. As you can see here, crack opening and closing behavior is clearly detected by DIC technique. And this is the strain duration. As you know, strain is conventionally used to detect the correct opening point for long graphs such as CT specimen. And of course, strain gauge cannot detect the correct opening point for such a small fatty crack. However, the strain measured by DIC is able to be clearly detect the crack opening point as shown here. Strain is measured just ahead of the crack tip. This is similar to crack tip opening displacement. So I will discuss about the crack closure effect by using this DIC technique. This shows the relationship between effective strain measured by DSC versus SWT parameter as shown before. As you can see here, SWT parameter is approximately proportional to effective strain. So this is indicated that SWT parameter is indirectly includes the crack opening closing behavior, and so this parameter is applicable for small fatigue crack growth rate evaluation. So finally, I'd like to show the relative result using effective fracture mechanics parameter, delta J effective. As you can see here, all fatigue data are uniformly evaluated by delta J effective. These are another structured data. Unfortunately, interestingly, also microstructures completely different, but microstructure effect is not clear for this evaluation. This evaluated result is, in other words, particular growth rate for ideal crack. So microstructure effect is not clear for ideal crack in this study. So in other words, microstructure effect is mainly appeared by crack closure effect. This is the rather important point for this presentation. This is the conclusion for this presentation. Thank you for your attention.